In this video, we're going to discuss trigonometric inequalities. These are going to start off very similar to trig equations. We are going to bring everything to one side, set it equal to zero, and solve that trig equation. Then we can use one of two tools to solve the inequality. We can either, if the graph is easy enough to visualize, use the graph, or we can use a sine chart like we often did in regular inequalities when we were solving things with multiple terms. Let's look at an example. Example one is a fairly straightforward. When is the sine of x less than or equal to zero? You probably can just do this from thinking about the unit circle yourself, but I want to think about this in terms of the steps of going through it step by step. So the instructions for this are going to be to find the exact answer in interval notation, restricting for x being between 0 and 2 pi. So we have some sort of ending, and we're not doing the generic plus pi k or anything like that because that gets a little complicated. So we're just going to solve between 0 and 2 pi. So for starters, everything is already to one side. So I'm going to ask myself, when is sine of x equal to 0? So I can think about the unit circle. Sine is the y value, so it's equal to 0 here and here. So that's x equal to, it's the y value. So not there and there, it's the y value here and here. So you can think of that as 0 and pi and 2 pi if we go all the way to 2 pi. So that's where it's equal to 0. Now, here's the first option. We can look at the graph of the sine function, which looks something like this. This is 2 pi, this is pi. So when is it less than or equal to 0? Well, that's in here. So that's in the interval pi to 2 pi, and we can include the endpoints because we're including equal to 0 there. So there's our answer, and that's how we do it using a graph. Or, of course, you can think about the unit circle and where the y value is less than 0 on the unit circle. So now we're going to discuss another one. The cosine of 2x is greater than or equal to 0. I'm going to treat this as a multiple angle question and think about it that way. You can certainly also use trig identities and transfer it into something different if you like. But I'm going to say first, everything's already to the side, so I can just ask, when is the cosine of 2x equal to 0? Well, that's when this angle, 2x, is equal to pi over 2 or 3 pi over 2. So that's when x is pi over 4 or x is 3 pi over 4 plus pi k. So this would be plus 2 pi k and this would be plus 2 pi k. This is plus pi k plus pi k. The reason why that's important is because x gets to be between 0 and 2 pi, so we actually have to figure out when 2x is between 0 and 4 pi. So we'll think about that. I'll start off with thinking about the unit circle. So 2x is equal to 0 when x is pi over 2, but when x is pi over 4, the cosine of double the angle is equal to 0. So that's pi over 4, and 3 pi over 4 we have equals 0. And then it also occurs plus pi k down here at 5 pi over 4, and over here at 7 pi over 4. All right, now we can use this idea right here, or we can go ahead and it's totally fine if you're going to just look at the unit circle and think about where this value is positive or negative. That's totally okay, but I'm going to use it in our chart. We're going to go from 0 to pi over 4, from pi over 4 to 3 pi over 4, from 3 pi over 4 to 5 pi over 4, 5 to 7, then we'll squeeze in here at the end, 7 pi over 4 to 2 pi. So those are all the intervals we need to test. Again, I'm going to give myself the little reference here to give me a visual to think about it. So I'm trying to consider the cosine of 2x. Is that positive or negative in each of these spots? So the chart notation, we would pick something in between, let's say like pi over 6. Pi over 6 is between 0 and pi over 4. So the cosine of 2 times pi over 6 is the same as the cosine of pi over 3, and that is definitely a positive quantity. Okay, so find something between pi over 4 and 3 pi over 4. How about pi over 2? Maybe that doesn't work so well because the cosine is 0. So why don't we go just a little bit more? So pi over 4, let's go to pi over 3. So pi over 3, the cosine of 2 times pi over 3 is over here in this quadrant, so it's negative. Okay, how about between 3 pi over 4 and 5 pi over 4? Well, we can use pi. The cosine of 2 times pi, we look at cosine of 2 pi, that's equal to 1, so that's a positive quantity. Now, most of the time, these are going to alternate between positive and negative, but you do want to be careful about that. So you do want to keep going and go ahead and think about this. So let's see, 5 pi over 4, let's go with 4 pi over 3. That's in that. So the cosine of 2 times 4 pi over 3 is the cosine of 8 pi over 3. So where is that? I'm going to give myself a little unit circle here. So let's see, here's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's right here, so that's negative. And then between 7 pi over 4 and 2 pi, let's go with like 11 pi over 6. So the cosine of 22 pi over 6. So there's 6, 12, 18, 22 puts me here. I guess if you like, you can convert this to 11 pi over 3. So you know you're over here, so it's positive. Okay, so going back to the original, we wanted cosine of 2x to be greater than or equal to 0. So that's here, here, and here. So we go from 0 to pi over 4. Union 3 pi over 4 to 5 pi over 4, union 7 pi over 4 to 2 pi. You can also think about this as, look at these sections. Really, we can take out these section breaks. It's positive here, negative, positive, negative. So that can help you go around that little circle a little bit. All right, next example. Okay, here we can make things a little more interesting. Okay, we want the sine of 2x to be greater than or equal to the sine of x. So move everything to one side. Minus the sine of x is greater than or equal to 0. Notice I didn't like divide by sine of x or do something illegal, right? I'm going to transfer sine of 2x into 2 times sine of x times the cosine of x. Again, I'm not going to divide by sine x because I'm not allowed to just divide by something that might be equal to 0 sometime. I can, however, factor it out. So that's important because the sine of x has some value to us. This is equal to 0 when the sine of x is equal to 0, or when 2 cosine x is equal to 1, or sorry, 2 cosine x minus 1 is equal to 0, so that means cosine x is 1 half. So the first one happens when x is 0 or pi, or I guess 2 pi. And the next one is when x is pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3, because we're looking just at positive 1 half. Okay, so intervals. Let's see if we can fit them on this page. 0 to pi over 3. You know what? I don't think it's going to fit, so I'm going to go on the next page. Now here's where the sine chart helps even more in this case, because we have two portions. We have the sine of x, and we have 2 cosine of x minus 1. We're going to consider whether each of those is positive or negative, and then whether the product is positive or negative. I'm going to get my little unit circle going on down here. So if I'm between here, so I have this section, this section, and this section. I have 4 sections to deal with. Okay, from 0 to pi over 3, sine is the y, so this is positive. From pi over 3 to pi, it's positive. Here it's negative and negative. Okay, now how about 2 cosine x minus 1? Let's look at this first little bit here. From 0 to pi over 3, cosine is bigger than 1 half. So that means 2 times the cosine of x is bigger than 1, so that makes this a positive quantity. Now, in the second area here, cosine is either smaller than 1 half or negative. Clearly, if it's negative, this quantity, 2 times a negative number minus 1, is negative. If it's less than a half, this guy's less than 1, so that's negative. So it's all negative. And in this next section, which we're dealing with from here to here, we have either cosine is negative or it's less than a half. So again, it's going to be negative. So here's where we needed to actually analyze these things, because it didn't just go plus minus, so you got to be careful there. And then lastly, in this section, it is positive and it is greater than 1 half, so it is, that quantity is positive. So here we go, we got positive, negative, positive, negative. So we wanted positive, so we have from 0 to pi over 3, union pi to 5 pi over 3. Okay, so hopefully so far that's been pretty straightforward. The next example gets a little bit more complicated. So secant squared of x is less than or equal to 4, so secant squared of x minus 4 is less than or equal to 0. So I'm going to solve secant squared x minus 4 equal to 0 to find my endpoints. So that's secant squared is equal to 4, or the secant is plus or minus 2. So secant is 1 over the cosine, so that means cosine is plus or minus 1 half, because I remember everything in terms of sines and cosines, so that's why I did that. So this occurs at x equal pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, 4 pi over 3, and 5 pi over 3. So those are some endpoints. Now be careful, because secant is undefined in a few places. Secant of x is undefined when cosine is equal to 0. So that's at pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So those also have to be endpoints. So we got a lot of endpoints to keep track of. Definitely need a new page for this. I'll write them all down. Okay, so we have equal to 0 at pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, 4 pi over 3, and 5 pi over 3. So really we're dealing with 4 sections here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we just have a little blip in the radar at pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So that's what to remember. It's not going to change the sign in there. It's just going to be undefined at that point. So we don't really have to think about these two separately, They are going to be the same, either positive or negative. There's just a blip in between them. Okay, so let's start with 0 to pi over 3 in this section right here. We're talking about secant squared of x minus 4. So let's do something like pi over 4. Secant squared, remember that's 1 over the cosine. Cosine there is square root of 2 over 2. Square it, that's 2 over 4. Flip it over, that's 2. So So we have 2 minus 4. This guy's negative. All right, from pi over 3 to pi over 2, we can think about this again. Cosine, this is 1 over the cosine. So cosine from here to here is less than a half. So that means cosine squared is going to be less than a quarter. So if cosine squared is less than a quarter, its reciprocal is greater than 4. So that makes this positive. Hopefully you followed all that. Okay, so from, and I said, as I said, if this guy's positive, then so is this guy, because that's just a blip in the radar, so we don't need to test that. Then over here, we've got the same kind of argument. Over here, the cosine is greater than a half. So that means that its reciprocal, that its squared is going to be greater than a quarter. So that means its reciprocal is less than 4. So that means this is going to be negative. And there was no blip here. We could really think about this not even being here. We're still in this section right here. So that's all negative. So again, same argument. We're going to see that this section is positive and positive. You can test a point in there if you like. You can even test an angle measure that you know is in there and use your calculator to test it. But it is going to be positive, the same argument that the cosine is less than a half. So squared is less than a quarter. Flip it over, it's greater than 4. And then again, this is in the same section really as this one. So this is negative. Positive, negative. And we were looking for less than 0. So we were looking for negatives this time. So that's those sections. So from 0 to pi over 3. From 2 pi over 3 to 4 pi over 3. Oops, that should be union. And from 5 pi over 3 to 2 pi. There we go. And we didn't have to worry about the soft brackets anywhere because we didn't actually hit on those interim parts because we were looking for less than or equal to 0. All right, so that one was a bit more complicated than the others in terms of analyzing those points, but hopefully you can go through there and really work with that unit circle. I really, really encourage you to be thinking about it on here, thinking about it in terms of sines and cosines. Put it into a sine chart like this so that you can find the answers from there. A few steps more than a trig equation, but the similar kind of process.